By the end of the video, you're going to learn whether tools like Replit's AI agent can replace website builders like Webflow. In this video, you're going to watch me do a speedrun using Replit's AI agent to code a full accounting website with a blog and an admin section, and I'm just going to watch. So I'm going to prompt it, tell it what to do, give it feedback, but it's going to code everything for me. If after the video you want to learn more about coding with AI, with ChatGPT and Replit, check the link in our description. In this project, we're going to have Replit build us a website for an accounting firm. So I'm just going to describe what I want to make, which is a website for an accounting firm. I want it to have multiple pages as well as a way to submit information to get in contact with the firm. Please use modern responsive design. Make the website cool and modern. So we'll go ahead and click start building. And it's just telling us that it's in early access and it's going to do its best. So we'll click continue. So now Replit is automatically creating this for you, and it jumps you into this chatbot first, which is kind of cool. And it's going to think about what we asked it to create, and then it's going to tell us what it's going to build, as well as potentially propose different features that we want to add. So I'm going to read this very quickly. So it's asking if I want to add any features such as a client portal, a blog section, an appointment scheduling system, or integrating with social media. So I'm going to check off a blog and then leave the others unchecked for now. So I'm going to go ahead, approve plan, and start. So here, down here, it's pretty cool. On the right side, Replit is going to tell us what it's doing and what it's creating. It's kind of doing a lot of configuration right now. And then on the left side, we can see what it's generating. So it's essentially a no-code tool that Replit has built, but it's built with AI, so you don't have to know how to code. You don't have to know what it's doing. It's helpful to kind of have a high-level understanding of how it all works for debugging later on. But on a high level, you don't have to know anything other than English and be able to tell the AI what you want it to do. So it's continuing to generate everything here. It just takes a little bit of time to get everything kind of set up and all the folders created. So I'm going to go ahead and pause and just let it finish with all of this setup. Okay, so it's gone through all of that initial setup and it's created this very basic page so far. And it looks like there are multiple pages that we can click through and a contact form. So it says, is the website loading correctly? Can you see the homepage with the welcome to our accounting firm message? So I'm just going to say, yes, I can see all that. And then what Replit is going to do is it should basically just kind of confirm that it did it correctly. It's reviewing to making sure that the requirements are met, and it's going to update us once it has more information. So it's, I think what's going to happen is it's going to confirm that it did it correctly and then ask us what we want to do next. Okay, so now it wants us to check all of the pages to making sure that they're all accessible and working correctly, which I did before, but I can see, yes, on a basic level, those are created. It looks like it didn't create the blog yet. And then the contact form, it wants me to fill this out and see if it's working correctly. So here I filled in my information. I'm interested in working together. And let's click send and see what happens. Okay, so it says an error occurred. Please try again. So let's tell it what happened. The pages are working and displaying, but the contact form says, and I'll just copy the error code, when I try to submit information. Okay, cool. So this is kind of a lot of the work that you're doing here with Replit. Is basically debugging it and trying to see, you know, if it didn't work, what went wrong and how to fix it. So pretty cool. On the right side, it says they've identified an issue. They're working on fixing it. So kind of cool how they build it in a way that it really feels like you are working with a team that's building your app. So it's restarting it. It's thinking again. It's probably going to ask me to try again. Okay, so it wants us to fill it out again. So let me do that real quick. So, hello, I'm interested in working together. Let's click send message. Cool. So it says, thank you for your message. We'll get back to you soon. So let me say, I think it worked. I got a success message, but I don't know how to verify if, it actually worked or was received or where the message went. So let's see what it says to that. And just something else to note, I'm generally pausing the video while the AI is thinking. Right now, it does take a little bit of time in between it kind of thinking and fixing it. This is something that I think in the future, if this was instantaneous, then it would be a lot more delightful to use and just a little bit easier and quicker to kind of go through and build these sites. Because it takes some time. If it's going to take, 2 minutes every time you ask for a change, that adds up when you're, building a site. Obviously, it's still a lot faster than building it on your own, but just something that I'm kind of noticing as I am using it. Okay, so what it did is it said it's going to create an admin page to view all of the submitted messages. Okay, so it wants us to test out by logging with the password admin123. So let's try that out and log in. Cool. Okay. So pretty cool. It created an admin dashboard for me and I do see the message. So let me say, great. That worked. Is it possible for me to get notified with an email when a new message comes in? So let's see what it says to that. Okay. So it's just asking where I want the emails to go. I'm just going to give it my email and let's see what happens. Cool. It's installing SendGrid, which is pretty cool. It's which is a way to send emails, and it's restarting it now. Okay, so it wants me to actually add a SendGrid API key to actually build in the sending functionality. Right now, I don't really want to go through that process of creating a SendGrid account and adding an API key. So I'm just going to say I'll do this later. Let's move on to other features for now and come back. So let's just see what it says to that. Okay, so pretty amazing. It says, sounds good. We're going to move on to the blog section, which was in the initial instructions, but it didn't build that yet. So it knew to build that, which is pretty awesome. So it's thinking and it's going to build that. Okay, so it's asking us if I can access the blog page. So I'm going to click on blog. And I can, and then can I access the admin page and see an option to add a new blog? So I think it's /admin, and let's put in the password, which was, I think, admin123. And then in the admin dashboard, it built a way to add a new blog post. So I'm going to say test blog. This is test content. And I'm going to add the post. And then it looks like it just put us to the blog page. And I can see that it did create that blog, which is pretty cool. I'm going to say yes to all. However, I can't click into a specific blog post because it looks like it created the blog. But I can't click into it. It would just show kind of all the blogs. So it's going to, I think, and let's see if we can add that now. Cool. Okay. So it's adding that feature. Okay. So now let's go to blog. And it's asking me to check to see if it worked. There is a read more, button. I can also click here and here we go. So it's blog and then it has the ID and yes. So now it does have, blogs for all of those. So I'm going to say yes. So it looks like it did successfully do that. So let's see what it says next. So what's cool is Replit basically then just created a milestone, which says it built the initial prototype, which is everything that we had in that first prototype. And now anytime we want, we can roll back to this stage of the app. So if we build more in the future and it doesn't work, we don't like it, we can roll back to build the initial prototype. So now let's see what it's going to suggest next. Okay, pretty cool. So I didn't even ask it for this, but it's already improving our blog by adding category filters. So if I click on different category filters, it looks like it's working correctly because it's not showing any blogs under those categories, and this doesn't have a category. But let's go to /admin and see if we can add a blog post with a category like it's suggested. It looks like we don't have edit blog post ability right now, but that's fine. So let's say test financial tip, content test, and then this is where we can add the category. We can add the post, and now we can see this does have the category, and then if you go to this category, it is working. So I'm going to say yes, that all works. Okay, so it says it's completed it successfully, and now it's saying, am I ready to share it with the world? I could deploy it. Let's say it's not quite ready yet. I want to add some more sections to the homepage. I want to add the contact form to the homepage, and I also just want to make the design a little bit better. Say, great, let's add a couple more things. Add the contact form to the website, the homepage as well. And then I want to improve the overall design. I want to add an image to the home page header section. And I want the entire site to be designed as if it were created by a professional web designer with 10 years of experience. It should look like a very professional accounting firm based on the design. Okay, so let's see what happens. This is, I've never done this before, so I'm going to see what happens kind of prompting it in this way. With the design suggestions. So let's see what happens. So first, it looks like it's going to add the contact form to the homepage. So let's see how it does there. Okay, so it's asking if it was visible on the homepage, and I'm going to say there's a button on the homepage, but not the form itself. Can you put the form under form itself on the bottom of the homepage? Okay. Okay, so it said it added a contact form to the homepage, but it didn't. So let me tell it to do that one more time. Looks like the contact form is still not on the homepage. There's just a button to go to the home contact page. Okay, so let's see what happens here. Okay, cool. So it actually took a long time to do this, actually 5 minutes. And I'm thinking that's just because there's a lot of people using Replit's AI right now, and it's sometimes just kind of getting backlogged. But it looks like yes is the full contact form on the website, and it wants me to test it. So it is on the homepage, and let me fill it out. It also added some more information to the contact form, which let's see if that's also on the contact. So here the contact page doesn't have all of that information, so something that we could also change in the future. Okay, so I filled it out. Let's click send message, and it says an error occurred. So let me let them know that, and let's let it think through this. Okay, so let's try this one more time, and let's go ahead and click send message, and we got an error again. So let me just see if I remove these dashes in the phone, if that makes any difference. And it looks like it doesn't. So I'm going to say an error occurred. Please try it again. Same error message. Okay, cool. So it says it is fixing it and adding a field to the database, which makes sense. It's kind of what I was thinking it might be potentially. And it restarted it, so let's try this one more time. And I am still getting an error message. So I'm going to say still the same error message. And this is where it can get a little tricky if you are using Replit AI to build your app and you don't know how to code, is, it could be getting this bug, and it might be really easy to fix if I could kind of just go in and understand what's happening. But since I don't, I just have to kind of keep telling it that it has the same error. All right, let's try this one more time. And we're still getting the same error message. So let's not worry about that right now. Let's just tell it it's still not working, but let's not worry about it now and come back later. Can you move on to the design requests I had? Okay, cool. So it made some changes here, and it's asking us if we see a header image. I don't. Updated color scheme, yes. Typography, yes. Subtle animations when scrolling or hovering over elements, I do see some of those as well. And the contact form. So I'm going to say everything, yes, but I don't see a header image. So now it's saying it's going to add a header image to the website. I'm not sure where it's going to get that image from or if it's going to ask me for an image. Let's see what happens here. So the image still isn't there. What I'm going to say is I'm going to attach an image, which I got from Pexels, which is an open source place to get images from. I'm going to say, here's an image. Please use it as the header image. And let's see if it's able to do that if I give it the image itself. Okay, cool. So now it was able to add that, it looks like. It's just refreshing. So you just have to give it that image so that it knows what image to use here. So, okay, pretty cool. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and pause there. But with the complete help of AI, we've built a website that has the ability to have a contact form, which we could fix that on the homepage if we play with this a little bit more. We have different pages, which we could also just tell it more information about what we want on these pages, have it add images. We could prompt it to do that. An about section, which we could prompt it to change. We have a blog. And then we also have an admin section, which allows us to log in with a password. We can see our contact submissions, and it also was going to have a way for us to receive emails when we get a submission, which we could enter a SendGrid API to have it do that. And then we can add blog posts and give them categories as well. And we could also prompt it to allow us to edit those blogs and kind of build more of a CMS around that. But pretty cool. I think this is a really helpful exercise just to understand what's possible now with AI, kind of where it's really good and where it's a little bit more frustrating and not as kind of seamless to work at compared to using tools like Webflow or Card to build your website. I think there's certain parts of this that are a lot easier than using those tools, but there's certain parts of it that are a lot harder and actually would just be a lot easier to use a no-code tool. So it's a very interesting space to watch. If you want to learn more about coding with AI, we have a brand new course that just came out that teaches how to use ChatGPT and Replit to build websites and apps. So we have a full course on building a web portfolio website, building a Slack bot, and building a Chrome extension. And in those courses, we're going to get a little bit more into the code. So you're not going to be coding yourself, but you're going to understand a little bit more what's behind the scenes here, as opposed to only prompting AI and having it kind of do it for you. So I think it's a really great course. Check out the link in the description if you want to go check that out. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to keep getting free content here, and leave a comment below if you have any questions. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.